Components bundle up functionalities that can be reused and shared with others via the KNIME Hub and KNIME Server. These functionalities can range from simple tasks that you often repeat in your own workflows, like entering credentials to a database, to more complicated tasks such as optimizing parameters. To use components as any KNIME nodes, they have to be shared. Let's have a look at how to do that. Here you can see a component that pre-processes sales data. It filters the data based on the date and country that has been selected in the configuration dialog, and it sorts the output data according to the selected column. Now, imagine you have multiple workflows where you would like to use the same pre-processing component. What you could do is copy and paste the component from one workflow to the others. However, if you changed the component in one workflow, the updates won't be triggered to the others. This will happen, though, if you share the component and link to it in all the workflows. To share a component, we right-click it and select Component, Share. A dialog opens asking for a destination workflow group for the shared component. We select a location in our local workspace. We could also connect to a KNIME server on the KNIME Hub to share the component with colleagues or the KNIME community. After clicking OK, another dialog opens asking for the link type. The link type defines how a workflow looks for the shared component when it checks for updates. If we create an absolute link, the workflow connects to the absolute location of the shared component. If we create a mount point relative link, the workflow connects to the shared component based on the folder structure under which mount point the workflow lives. Therefore, if we deploy the workflow to a KNIME server, we'll have to deploy the shared components as well and keep the path from the mount point to the component the same. If we create a workflow relative link, the connection between the shared component and a workflow that uses it is based on the folder structure between the workflow and the shared component. The last option creates a shared component but doesn't link this instance to it. The selected link type is used for this instance and as default link type for all other instances of the shared component created later on. We now click OK and the shared component appears here in the KNIME Explorer. To create an instance of it in the workflow, we drag and drop it to the workflow editor. The green arrow in the bottom left corner tells that the component is linked to a shared component. If we want to check the current link type, or if we want to customize the link type for a specific instance, we can do this in the dialog that opens when we right-click the component and select Component Change Link Type. If we now open the component, the workflow has a gray background, and we cannot change anything inside it. That's because the components that are linked are also write-protected. To make changes in this component, we'll first have to unlink it by right-clicking the component and selecting Component Disconnect Link. Now, we can make whatever changes we want. To update the shared component, we just override it. We right-click the component and select Component Share in the menu. We select the location of the currently existing shared component, and in the dialog that opens, we select to override it. If we are not sure where the shared component is located, we can right-click an instance of it and select Component, select an Explorer in the menu. This highlights the shared component in the KNIME Explorer panel. Next, let's have a look at how to make sure that the components link to the latest version of the shared component. If we right-click an instance of a shared component and select Update, the instance is compared with the latest version of the shared component. If updates are available, a dialog opens asking to update the component. A dialog asking to check for updates also opens every time we open a workflow that contains instances of shared components. Finally, let's have a look at how to use shared components available on the KNIME Hub. We right-click this shared component under the My KNIME Hub mount point in the KNIME Explorer and select Open. In KNIME Hub in the menu, from the KNIME Hub page that opens, other users can drag and drop the component to your workflow editors. In this video, we have shown how to share components and link to them in workflows. We have explained how to make changes to shared components and how to update instances of shared components accordingly. Components can be reused locally and shared via KNIME Server and KNIME Hub.